I'm Maria Calvo and I'm going to explain a section of my final degree project, which is based on the concept of passive houses. This section can be included into the EcoThings program, of which my supervisor is a part. As can be seen, passive houses have disadvantages, but they also have many advantages, such as energy or cost savings, and the reduction of pollution. Within this concept, it's worth mentioning the existence of the standardization system from the Passive House Institute in Germany. There's no specific regulation for this type of houses in Spain, but this certificate is one of the most prestigious and recognized in Europe today. To obtain it, the criteria listed at the top of the slide must be met, and the Institute itself suggests a series of features to achieve certification, such as installing double or triple glazed windows. The third passive house covers many fields, but this project has focused on the heating and cooling system. There are two types of heating and cooling systems that use renewable energy sources, which I have based on to create the new air system for the prototype. These two systems are geothermal and aerothermal. On one hand, geothermal energy involves harnessing heat from the ground. And on the other hand, aerothermal energy follows the same process as geothermal energy, but the energy source used is the outside air. Now, I will explain the application in the prototype. First, it's important to mention that to print many of the necessary parts, two printers were used: the polylactic acid PLA printer and the resin printer. The PLA printer is used to obtain large and more durable parts, while the resin printer provides a more precise finish. The model is divided into three parts, and I will now focus on the installation section, specifically on the passive system. The heating and cooling system in the prototype is divided into two: the underfloor heating and the air system. As for the underfloor heating, it has only been installed, not implemented, since I consider it a future development. The system consists of a plastic tube simulating pipes arranged in a zigzag pattern to cover as much space as possible, and it passes through small wheels to ensure it stays well secured. And the air conditioning system consists of two tubes, also simulating pipe like in the underfloor heating, through which air is passed. The system offers greater sustainability compared to other systems that use heat transfer fluid, since, among other benefits, no chemicals are used. The system is made up of two tubes, a pump, two valves, two containers, and two funnels. The two tubes come from a pump, and depending on whether the interior of the house needs to be heated or cooled, the pump will turn on and air will flow through the tubes to the two valves. Depending on desired temperature inside the house, one of the two valves will allow the air to pass so it can go through one of the two containers. The tubes are inserted into the containers through spiral mechanisms, allowing for the maximum amount of tubing to be contained in each container. One container will be filled with hot water and the other with cold water, simulating a real air cooling and heating system. Once the air passes through one of the containers, it's directed to a funnel that introduces it inside the house. Solenoid valves were initially purchased, but the pump didn't have enough capacity to operate them, so it was decided to design them. Thus, a ball valve was designed with a simple mechanism using a servo motor to move the internal ball, allowing or blocking the passage of air. However, the design had to be modified to create the valve in three parts, as printing it as a single piece didn't allow the ball to move. Here you can see a container with a blue spiral mechanism where cold water will be introduced, and another container with a pink spiral mechanism where hot water will be introduced. Additionally, You can also observe the two funnels that lead inside the house. One of them is installed at the bottom, as it's where hot air, which tends to rise, will pass through. And the other funnel is at the top because cold air tends to go down. The code was created using the Arduino program and it has four functions. Focusing on the temperature function, as it's related to the passive system, it's important to note that the chosen temperature ranges are those stipulated by law in Spain for public places. This is a video when first you can see how the home automation part works and then the functioning of the system, of the passive system. By hitting the sensor with your finger or calling it with compressed air, the pump will turn on and the system will start running. In conclusion, it should be noted that by incorporating the concept of a passive house into the prototype, it has been possible to integrate, among other things, innovation, sustainability, and energy savings. Thank you.